In this next set of videos, we'll be looking at the screens under the Project Data tab, which is where you enter data applicable to the project as a whole. The first of these screens is the Project screen. On this screen, the three key things that you'll do are put in your project title, select your weather location and ambient design conditions, and specify your building rotation. While many items on this screen are self-explanatory, there are a few key things that I'd like to point out. The first of these is the before 1990 and after 1990 buttons here. These represent the two weather data sets that are currently available in CAMEL Plus. The before 1990 data set was created from historical weather data from the 80s and 90s, and the after 1990 data set uses data generally from around 1990 to 2012, but it does vary depending on the weather station. The years that the design conditions are based on are shown below the table here. This year, we'll be looking to release a new set of design conditions based on weather data from the year 2000 until the end of 2021, so watch this space. In selecting your weather location, you can click the Select Map button to bring up a map. This allows you to select your state, navigate to your site location, and then click and apply to select the most appropriate weather location. You can toggle which weather data sets are displayed on the map here. Note that some weather stations have either moved or closed down between the before 1990 and the after 1990 data sets, so be sure to consider this when selecting the most appropriate weather location for your project. The All Age Use Single Zone Single Room box here simplifies the data input screens and can be used when all air handling units are single zone units, each with only one room. Some people like this feature, but I generally don't recommend it because it disables the tree structure screen, which is a powerful tool that can be used to quickly set up all of your age use. I won't go into detail for the design condition inputs here, but you can hold down Alt and left click on any field for more information. Next is the building rotation, which can be adjusted using the buttons here or by entering in an angle in degrees. It's important to note that this is actually displayed differently to the original CAMEL software. In CAMEL Plus, True North is always pointing upwards, and what you are rotating in the image is building north. The angle nominated is the rotation from true north to building north. Positive is clockwise and negative is anti-clockwise. Looking at this example of a north arrow from a drawing, the rotation between true north and building north is 100 degrees clockwise, so you enter in a positive 100 here, which represents this angle. Moving down to the bottom of the screen, you can specify your default plant operating times here, which will be used in the absence of any specific schedules that you set up. If applicable, you can also enter the ambient design conditions for any desiccant humidity control units that you are using. Finally, the shading effectiveness options here are usually left unticked. This is a feature that can be used to help calculate certain parameters for the BCA glazing calculator spreadsheet. These do not affect the results of your heat load calculation, but they can slow down processing time significantly. That's all for this video. Please join me in the next one, where we'll be taking a look at the schedule screen. Bye for now.